माय डियर चिल्ड्रेन, होप ऑल आर सेफ एट होम। दिस इज कार्तिका टीचर। टुडे लेट अस स्टार्ट ए न्यू टॉपिक, पॉलिनोमियल्स। एज यू हैव स्टडीड अर्लियर द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल, इन दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ ए पॉलिनोमियल ऑफ डिग्री एन and the relationship between zeros and coefficients of a polynomial. So first of all, let us see what is the general form of a linear polynomial. The general form of a linear polynomial is ax plus b equal to 0, where a and b are constants and a should not be 0. Similarly, the general form of a quadratic polynomial is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, where a, b, c are constants and a should not be 0. So in general, what you can say about the polynomial of degree n form, that is a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus etc., an minus 1 x raised to n minus 1 plus an s raised to n, where a0, a1, etc., an are constants and an should not be 0. Let us see how we can find out the relationship between the zeros and coefficients of a polynomial. For that, here we are going to deal with a quadratic polynomial. So as we know, the general form of a quadratic polynomial is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, where a, b, c are constants and a should not be 0. Let alpha and beta be the zeros of the given polynomial. P of x is equal to ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Then sum of zeros is equal to minus b by a. That means minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square. The sum of zeros is minus b by a, that is equal to minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square. Product of zeros is equal to c by a, that is equal to constant term divided by coefficient of x square. Let us see with the help of examples how we can find out the zeros of a polynomial and the relationship between the zeros and coefficient, how we have to verify that. For that, let us see one example. Find the zeros of a quadratic polynomial a square plus 7x plus 10 and verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients. So whatever be the question, first you must see the general form of a polynomial p of s. Here in this question, p of s is equal to s square plus 7x plus 10. So first what we have to do means, we have to split the middle term. Last year we studied factorization of polynomials, isn't it? So like that way, x square plus 7x plus 10, the middle term is 7s and the last term, constant term, is 10. So you have to split the polynomials in two. Here the product and sum you have to consider. The product becomes the coefficient of s square, the product of the coefficient of s square into the constant term. And the middle term is the sum of the zeros. So first let us see that we will have the product as 10 and sum as 7. So we have to find two numbers such that the product is 10 and sum is 7. So what will be the two numbers? 5 and 2, isn't it? So you have to split the 7s, middle term 7s, in terms of 2x plus 5x. So s square plus 7s plus 10 equal to x square plus 2x plus 5x plus 10. Then see the first two terms. X is the common factor. So take the common factor outside. So x into x plus 2 plus Here 5x and 10, we will have 5 as a common factor. So 5 into x plus 2. Again you see that s plus 2 is within bracket, isn't it? So s plus 2 is again a common factor, you take it outside. So x plus 2 into x plus 5. So p of x equal to 0 implies x plus 5 into x plus 2 equal to 0, which gives x is equal to minus 5 or x is equal to minus 2. Therefore, minus 5 and minus 2 are the zeros of the given polynomial s square plus 7s plus 10. So first what we have to do means, first using factorization, whatever be the polynomial, we have to factorize into and find out the values of x, that is the zeros of the polynomial. Then apply the formula what I discussed you earlier, sum of zeros, alpha plus beta, what I said the formula, minus b by a, that is minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. Here sum of 0, the two zeros we got as minus 5 and minus 2. So sum of zeros is equal to minus 5 plus minus 2, that is equal to minus 7. That minus 7 is same as minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square, isn't it? That is same as minus b by a. So adding the sum of two zeros, we are getting the same result. Using the formula also, we are getting minus 7 as the same result. Same manner, we have to find out the product of zeros. Product of zeros is equal to minus 5 into minus 2. That is equal to minus into minus, what will come? Positive, isn't it? So minus 5 into minus 2, that is 10. That is same as the constant term divided by coefficient of s square. Here in this polynomial, the constant term is 10 and the coefficient of s square is 1. So 10 divided by 1, that is equal to 10. So hence we verified the result. Understood clearly, children?